Hello everyone, this is Josef Notch here, and welcome back to the second part of the tutorial where I'm talking about turbulence modeling. In the first part I was talking about RAS and LES models, and I showed the source code of BISOFOAM, and I set up the base case of simulation that we will do with three different turbulence models, and I will immediately jump into the K epsilon model, the RAS model that we will take a look at. And since I set up everything for the K epsilon model, I can just type in BISOFOAM and press enter, and now the simulation will start and the simulation is running. It's rather fast because it is a two-dimensional simulation and the mesh is very coarse. Let's wait until 0.2. And I will just go in a separate terminal into the tutorial folder, BISOFOAM in LES, and then a K epsilon model. Very good. And I will open up ParaView here in the separate folder, in a separate terminal, because if you remember back in the last tutorial, we saw that there is a weird error message in ParaView in regard to epsilon. But let's just wait. Again, I will take a look at the output here, and then I will take a look at the results in ParaView. Again, in BISOFOAM, we now have an actual physical time. This is not the change of the flow from the initial 0, 0, 0 velocity field and the pressure field with zero, pressure divided by density, towards the stationary results. But this is actually the physical evolution of the flow as you would see it in experiments. So again, let's just wait until 0.2. Simulation will run for 100 seconds approximately, or a little bit more, at least on my laptop, yes. So we have here time equals 0.2. So now this is an actual time step. This is our last time step. The Courant number is smaller than 1, which is good. Then you have ux and uy, initial residuals of 10 to the power of minus 5 and 4. For p we have minus 5. And in the second outer loop we have minus 6. And for epsilon we have minus 5 and minus 5. As you saw in the previous tutorial, 10 to the power of minus 5 was a rather good guess for the steady state simulation, and for the transient simulation it is also a good guess. So I will say that with these values we are convergent within a given time step. So I will start ParaView, and I will take a look at the results now of the K epsilon model. I will show you the velocity field. You can check all the other fields. I do not want to waste your time here. You can do it now on your own, and you can do the evaluation of lines with a sample dictionary or plot over line here in ParaView on your own. I want to concentrate here on the difference between RAS models and LES models. Okay, for that I will show you the velocity field, and here is the weird error message. I will ignore that error message, and what we have here is the time evolution of the flow, and as you see here we have a backflow, as we found also in the steady state simulations, and this backflow region grows as time progresses, and after 0.2 seconds we see a flow field, a velocity field, which is very, very similar to the steady state result or in simple form. So this looks rather promising. Now let's take a look at the results with the, with the LES simulations. Okay, for that I will enter the Smagorinsky case. I will start with the simple model, and for that in 0 we only need new SGS, P and U. We do not need the RAS values, k and epsilon and nu t. So I will just delete those. And again, we do not need a k value because we do not have a transport equation. So I will just delete also the... Okay, so we have new SGSP and U. And constant, we have to change the RAS model. So I will uncomment this line and use LAS models. And in the LAS properties, I will delete the one equation at the end. I want to use the Smagorinsky model. This is why I set up this case, because I'm very lazy. And I can just leave the RAS properties or delete it. In transport properties, we set the viscosity to 10 to the power of minus 5, but we will use this value. And in system, we do not need to change anything. So I will start PisoFOAM. The simulation is running, but as I mentioned before, in this case, there is no additional equation for k. So we are only solving the equations for u and p. So let's just wait. To 0.2. And maybe I stop recording here and come back when the simulation finishes in about a minute. Okay, the simulation stopped. And let's take a look at the output. We have a Courant number of smaller than 1. We have an initial residual of 10 to the power of minus 3, more or less a little bit above in P. And as you see, there is no additional equation after the P equation. So now let's just take a look at the results here in ParaView. I want to go into Smago and foam.foam. I have to translate, of course, this. Very good. Translate it. No, stop. Okay, 0. Good. And I want to show you the velocity. And now, as you see, in the beginning, the two models predict a very similar velocity field. You have this backflow here, you have, which you also find here, but as the flow progresses, you find a second eddy. And now I use the word eddy, but again, please take care not to mix up laminar vortices and this turbulent phenomena. So if I say eddy, I mean only and only turbulent phenomena. And what with eddy, I mean that something is turning round and round. Okay, this is what I mean with turbulent eddies. I don't use the word vortex because you will also find vortices in laminar flows. I talked about that in the previous tutorial. So here we find these turbulent eddies, and in the RAS model, in the K epsilon model, we only find one huge backflow region. And if I go further, we even find a third eddy here, detaching from this step, and the eddies are moving downwind in the direction of the outlet. And we even find a fourth eddy, and these two eddies are coalescing for whatever reason in this model, and then the fifth eddy, and all the eddies are moving in the direction of the outlet. Now there is a definite difference between these two models, because here we have one huge backflow region and here we have multiple turbulent eddies. Now you might ask yourself which one is correct. Before I comment on that, I want to do the simulation with the one equation eddy model. For that, in 0 I delete epsilon, the RAS k value and nu t, and I will rename this to K, and these are the entries which we need. K for the transport equation of K, which we set up correctly. Then the new SGSP and U. In constant, I have to change here this entry. I want to use an alias model, and which I set here in alias properties, and I do want to use with one equation at the model, so I do not change anything here. And in system, we set up everything correctly, so I press now enter, and let's wait for the simulation to finish. And while the simulation is running, I want to talk about this delta value. This value here, and as I mentioned, this value is calculated out of the volume of your cells by taking the cube root in a three-dimensional simulation. But here we are doing two-dimensional simulations, and as you might already know, that in two-dimensional simulations in OpenFOAM we have an empty direction in which the equations are not solved. This is the Z direction in this case. And what OpenFOAM is actually doing, it is taking for a given cell, for example, this cell here in the corner, it is taking the empty length, so this length, and it is dividing the volume by this length. And what we have is the area of this face here, and it is taking the square root of this face. So this is how OpenFOAM is creating this delta. Okay, just for your information. And again, in three-dimensional cases, it is just taking the cube root. Now let's go back to the simulation. It will stop in about 10 seconds, maybe 15. So let's just wait. Okay, simulation stopped. We have a Courreau number of less than 1. And initial residuals of 10 to the power of minus 3 and 4, as you see here. But let's just take a look at the results in ParaView. One equation, eddy, foam.foam, apply. Let's translate. Okay, so this is the one equation, eddy model. And if I browse through now, in the beginning, again, we have similar results with one turbulent eddy here and this backflow region. But as the flow progresses, we find a second eddy being built up in these two cases. And these two cases are very, very similar. There are differences, as you see here in the colors, but it is very, very similar. Big differences between the LAS models and the RAS model. And again, if I browse through, you find the third eddy, but there is a definite difference. For example, this eddy is faster in the Smagorinsky model than in the one equation eddy model. And as I mentioned before, for example, here in the Smagorinsky model, these two eddies are coalescing, here not. So there is a difference between the models. But, as you see, the main difference is between the LAS models and the RAS models. And what's the reason? I ask the question, which one is correct? And in order to understand that, we have to think back again what we assumed with the models. In the RAS models, we say that we ignore all the scales of the oscillations. So here we are ignoring all of them, and we are putting all the oscillations into our new T value, the turbulent viscosity. So all the turbulent phenomena are put into this value. And here you see that here behind the step, these turbulent phenomena are happening. So here we have high turbulence. This is what this model assumes. On the other hand, in LAS simulations, we do not put all the turbulent phenomena into our model viscosity, but here we assume that we do resolve some of the scales, and we see here these eddies, these turbulent eddies. So we are depicting these and our geometries on the scale of centimeters. So we are depicting turbulent oscillations, these turbulent eddies on scales of centimeters. But we do not depict turbulent eddies on the scales of millimeters and, or micrometers or even smaller eddies. And those we are modeling with this new SGS. This is the subgrid scale viscosity, which introduces the additional viscosity because we do not depict the smaller scales, which are smaller than our grid, which are the subgrid eddies. So here you see, if I show you again the velocity, we have here this eddy, and on the edge of this eddy, our subgrid scale viscosity is high. So we will have here smaller eddies if we had a finer grid. Again, this grid is way too coarse, but also here we see that where this is high, there we would have also smaller eddies. And also the same is true here. And if you take a look at this new SGS, the order of magnitude is smaller, and there is a difference of at least one magnitude between the new T and the new SGS. Why? Because here we are resolving some of the turbulent values that you see here, these eddies here. But in the RAS models, we put the also these turbulent eddies into the new T value. So here we are putting everything into the new T value, and in the LES models, we are only putting the turbulent phenomena that we do not depict with our flow. So we only put part of the turbulence into new SGS. This is why new SGS is smaller than the new T in the RAS model. So I hope that now you have a slight idea of the difference between these two models. In the LAS models, we are depicting parts of the turbulence with our mesh. In the RAS models, we do not depict any of the turbulent eddies. And this is the assumption here. So, and to answer the question if this is correct or not, indeed there are researchers and engineers who question the validity of unsteady RAS simulations, but you have to know what you will see in your results. Here you won't see turbulent eddies, turbulent phenomena. Here you will only see a more or less mean value of your flow field. And if you are not interested in the detaching eddies in your simulations, because you have a huge volume with, for example, flaps or fins, and behind those flaps you have turbulent eddies, but your region of interest is far away, then you can use these RAS models, because you will have more or less the correct order of magnitude for the velocity there. If you're not interested in that, then it is okay, but if you are interested in these detaching eddies, then you have to use the LAS models. Okay, so I hope that now you see the difference between RAS models and LAS models. And the difference between the turbulent viscosity in RAS models and the subgrid scale viscosity. Here we are putting all the turbulent phenomena into the new T value, and here we are only putting parts of the turbulent phenomena which we do not depict with our grid. Okay, enough about turbulent values. At this point I would like to stop recording now. I hope that you enjoyed this tutorial and that you learned something. I would like to thank you for watching, and I hope to see you next time.